Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Stable Diffusion for Professional Creatives. Today we'll be taking a look at how we can turn Canva, a graphic design and compositing tool, into a generative AI powerhouse with the use of Stable Diffusion and LLMs. And we will see how we can get from these images over here to these results over here, while comping inside of Canva in real time, and then to a final result such as this one once we are satisfied with the quick comping. Same as always, you will be able to find the workflow, any models you need, any custom nodes you need in the description below, and I will be taking a deep dive into how this workflow works at the end of the video. In the meantime, let's jump into testing. So first of all, what is Canva? Well, Canva is a free tool, very easy to use, that is used for graphic designing and compositing. It's got tons of templates, texts, elements, anything you might want to do quick compositings and graphic design work. It even has some very limited AI image generation capabilities. Right now, it can only do text to image for images and graphics and some videos. But we sure aren't satisfied with those AI capabilities. We want to turn this thing into an AI beast. And in order to do that, we are using a Stable Diffusion backend, basically. This workflow here runs in the background while we work inside of Canva. And in order to do that, it uses either an Hyper SDXL model or a 1.5 LCM model. In my case, I am using Epiphotogasm LCM because it's faster than Hyper SDXL models, at least when used in conjunction with a ControlNet, an Ollama image describer node that is used in order to take care of prompting, a depth ControlNet, and the screen share node that we all know and love. If you are a longtime viewer of the channel, you know that I've been using the screen share a lot. And what this does for us, it allows us to screen capture basically anything that's happening on our computer. In this case, for example, I am screen capturing what's happening inside of Canva, and I am using that as an image source for an image-to-image workflow. So in order to set everything up, we just have to pick the model, pick the right settings for the case sampler, in my case, 8 steps, CFG1, and scheduler SGM uniform, a denoise value depending on how close or how far from our original comping we want the resulting image to be. And then we want to set the screen that we want to share to our Canva tab, and we want to set an area. This area will be our active area for our generations, and I am setting this square area in the middle of the Canva. Now that I've set everything up, I can hit live run and go back to Canva. Now inside of Canva, I can just start working. And every time the screen share node sees that something changes, it will launch a new generation. And the way we can work inside of Canva without going back and forth from comfyUI and seeing our results is by using a pop-up preview node. We can place the pop-up preview node anywhere on our screen, and it's going to give us a preview of the resulting image. So in this case, for example, if I want to take the perfume bottle, rotate it, maybe enlarge it a bit, and place it, let's say, right over here, I am going to get very quickly a preview of what I am getting inside of Stable Diffusion. Now, depending on your hardware, the generation process might be faster or slower. In my case, it's not properly real time, but I am also recording myself while I'm doing it. It would be much faster if I weren't. In your case, it could be immediate, it could be a lot slower. And that's why I've set a few different options for Hyper, LCM, or Lightning. So, for example, if we want to change the scenery completely and we want to remove everything around here, we could import a new background, for example, a forest, and the LLM would pick that up. As we can see in the prompt, we can see that we have a lush verdant forest with towering trees, etc., etc. So we don't have to care about fixing the positive prompt if we change anything. And while we are placing the element, we can see that Stable Diffusion is already starting to generate our background, for example, in this case. So let's say we wanted to place this branch over here where we want to put our perfume bottle. We can place that here. The generation would start anew and give us this branch. Now, if we want to go place the bottle of perfume as well, for example, we're gonna resize it a bit. We can see how the generations keep up while we're adding element after element. So let's add another branch, for example. We want to be layering this thing so that it gets more interesting. And instead of having to settle for a very, very rough comping or spending hours in Photoshop to edit it into something good, we can see that we get some good generations right off the bat. Now, of course, these first results are nothing to write home about. We are using an LCM, after all, or an hypermodel if you are using an hypermodel. But once we are satisfied with the preview comping and a preview generation, what we could do is go back into comfyUI and change our settings. So for example, we're going to stop the live share. We are going to change our checkpoint to a full one, a more fine-tuned one. So for example, I am going to change to Epic Realism Natural Scene. We are obviously going to tweak the settings as well. So we are going up to 20 steps, CFG7 and Cellular Caress. Everything else can remain the same, and we can hit Q prompt again. Now, while it's generating, please bear in mind that if you are using an LCM, you are using a ST1.5 ControlNet model. If you switch to a full checkpoint that is Excel based, you want to change the ControlNet accordingly as well. You can't run 1.5 ControlNet with Excel models and vice versa. And once we finish generating with our full checkpoint, we can see that the result is much better. So you don't really have to compromise. You can do quick prompting with LCMs or hypermodels and then do the full compositing, the full generation afterwards with a full model. And of course, this doesn't only work with specific bottle of perfume. And of course, this workflow is not only limited to a very specific category of products, but it also works with bags, shoes, people, anything really. And all the while, it preserves details and colors. And you are also not limited to Canva only. You can use Photoshop, you can use Illustrator, you can use anything you want. The process is basically the same. I am only using Canvas because it's free, it's web-based, and it's used by a ton of people. So now let's take a look at how this workflow works. Well, for starters, we've got three main groups. We got a Generate from Canva group, we got a Merge Original Subject group, and we got a Relight group. The first group, as we've seen, takes care of regenerating an image based on our rough Canva compositing, and that's done through an image-to-image process. The image gets grabbed from the Canva workspace through a screen share node. This image then gets resized at the appropriate sizing depending on how fast or how precise we want our generations to be. In my case, I am resizing it down to 1024 by 1024, and then the image gets encoded as a latent and used as a base. At the same time, the image gets passed through Adapt Anything V2 node that pre-processes the image as a depth map. This depth map is then used as a base for a ControlNet depth. ControlNets for 1.5 are a lot faster than ControlNet for SDXL, so that's why I'm using an LCM instead of on a hypermodel, but you can use a hypermodel as well. Because last week, a very good new depth ControlNet just dropped. It's the Sensor Depth model. You're gonna find it in the description below. And it's a very, very good depth model for Excel. The last building block that we would need normally is a positive prompt field, but we don't want to go back and forth between Canva and comfyUI. So what we do instead is use an LLM, in this case an Ollama image describer node, to create a prompt based on what Ollama sees. And that's our show text node here. We can see that it's describing the image. The image depicts a single red handbag with a visible brand logo on the side, etc., etc. So everything that is in the image gets described and used as a prompt. The end result here is an image that has been regenerated, and it's more cohesive, it's better than the comping that we were doing inside of Canva. The only issue, of course, is that our subject gets changed as well, and we don't want that because we are selling that product. So in order to fix that, we feed this image into a Merge Original Subject group. This group basically takes the original subject from the original image that gets grabbed with the screen share node through the use of a grounding dino sem segment node. And in this case, I forgot and I left perfume, but it still understood what I wanted. But let's say we wanted to revert it to bag, for example, and it overlays it on top of our regenerated subject, which we don't want. But at this point, we have an issue. The original subject is not well lit based on the regenerated image. So what we want to do in order to give it more cohesiveness is pass this image through a relighting step. And the long-time viewers of the channel will recognize this group because it's a very simplified version of my relighting while preserving details and colors workflow that I developed. So throughout this process, the image gets relit based on the global illumination, and then the colors are matched and the details are preserved. Now remember that IC Lite only works with 1.5 models, so regardless of whether you're using an LCM or an SDXL Hyper or Lightning model, you still want to be loading a 1.5 checkpoint. In my case, that's Epic Realism. The global illumination is an approximation based on the white points of the regenerated image. We treat those white points as sources of light, and we can see that we are creating here a light mask based on those white points. You can influence what's white by working on these threshold values. The higher the threshold value, the more colors are treated as white. And then we get here the real lit image, but the colors are kind of off and the details as well are not great. So what we want to do is use frequency separation in order to restore the details and color match the low frequency layers. This is the end result of the detail preservation and color matching process. And here we can see that before and after. So I really think that compositing-based regeneration and relighting processes are going to be the future of product photography. The technology behind it is not that intuitive, and the tools we have are not fine-tuned. I mean, the screen share node itself is very, very scuffed. It takes a ton of hardware processing in order to run all of this in close to real time. But still, we are still very early in this technology, and I can see that there is a future in this. And I am very excited about the possibilities of these processes. Take this image, for example. It would have taken ages in order to comp it properly, or it would have taken a whole shoot in order to get this. Instead, we can test out new ideas with rough compositing in almost real time directly on our computers. So I hope you find this workflow useful, and that's gonna be it for today. I want to take a brief moment to thank all of you who have supported me and keep supporting me on Ko-fi. I don't promote that as much because I don't like doing it, and donations are absolutely not necessary, but they're always appreciated. I hope you had some fun and learned something new today. If you wanna see more like this video, check out my 3D environment compositing based video. This video itself is a variation on that, based on some comments that I received on that video. My name is Andrea Baioni. You can find me on Instagram @rizunobushi or on the web @andreabaioni.com. And same as always, I will be seeing you next week.